TV. This is Business Notes. I'm Diane Bogino. Our guest today is Misty Williams. Misty Williams is the founder of Strategic Marketing Solutions, a marketing strategist and creator of Market Tech U. Misty works with speakers, coaches, and consultants to create the right business model, implement the right systems and processes, as well as develop the right team to grow their businesses. Misty is an expert in marketing strategy and business development. Her career began in artist management and marketing before she founded Strategic Marketing Solutions in 2004. Her clients include best-selling authors, nationally known speakers, and a plethora of experts who package their expertise as speeches, books, training and coaching programs, TV, radio guests, and more. Misty is a member of the American Marketing Association and has been a featured presenter for the National Speakers Association's annual conference. She has spoken for local and national associations across the country in both the speaking and coaching world. She's been a featured lecturer for Vanderbilt University, and she is highlighted in Who's Who among international business women. Misty, thank you so much for being with us tonight.
Oh, thank you for having me. I'm excited to be here.
So, Misty, you have developed a whole new coaching program. So tell us about that.
It's the Market Tech U Mastermind. This program actually is kind of the brainchild of some work that I did with a colleague who became a client and really got to peer into the work that I do on the marketing side with clients, and has helped to kind of bring some of the things that I've always done but have never really paid attention to or thought they're particularly valuable to the fore, and we're weaving it into all the marketing stuff and very, very excited about it. It's the big question that we ask is, what happens in your business when you run out of time? So,
and do you have the answer to that question?
Well, I mean, we don't want to focus on the whole thing cratering necessarily, but you know, we're busy as business owners, and there's always new ideas. And I mean, how many times have you gone to a convention and gotten marketing tips and strategies and things you knew you needed to execute, and when you got home, did it happen? Did you have time for it to happen? And what's happening in your business because that didn't happen, or because you were focusing on other things, or you know, there's a reality that we have to deal with, especially as we're micro businesses. Speakers in particular have most of the time very small businesses that can have, you know, a nice line of revenue, but they don't have 10 people working for them. Usually it's just the business owner. So, you know, as a business owner, how do we juggle this? How do we wear all the hats and deliver well and keep creating good product, and also put systems in place and get the right kind of leverage so that our businesses are scalable, so that we can actually execute on great ideas, you know, so that we can take advantage of the relationships we have in our life that are giving us insights and breakthroughs and whatever else. So, you know, what we want to do with Market Tech U is kind of weave in not only the strategy piece, but the leverage piece. You know, what do we have to do, and how do we have to grow, and who do we have to become as business owners to really actualize the full potential of what it is that we're trying to create. So it's really fun. I love it. I'm glad that we get to talk about things that I think are really interesting, but I really didn't think anyone else would be that interested in them. But you know, fortunately it's worked out for us, and I'm very excited about this program, and we're getting such great feedback from the people that are in our networks, Dan and I's network, about, you know, the value that they're getting out of it. I mean, it's not something that we talk about a lot. Dan even said, you know, in an email that he sent out to his list, that, you know, he wasn't looking for a business coach, and he didn't he needed a business coach, and, you know, the idea sounded almost absurd to him. And I actually don't call myself a business coach necessarily. I have positioned myself always more on the marketing side, but as we began to work together and I wanted to give him more work, the problem was he couldn't take it on. He didn't have the bandwidth, and he's brilliant at what he does, and I want to bring that to my clients, but we had a real, like, leverage problem going on. And so in order for us to continue working together, I began to help him, and it's turned his thinking inside out too. And you know, he reflected back to me the value of this piece of it and what I do. It's kind of the thing that my clients didn't know they were getting when they were signing up with me, you know, but it's a lot of the work we do is, this is great, we can have these great ideas, but who's going to do this? Because you're maxed. You know, how are we going to handle this? And then we have the fiscal reality of, you know, who has thousands and thousands of dollars to spend. So it's, you know, you kind of ease forward a little bit sometimes, yeah. But there's ways to do it. There's ways to do it. And it's really important for our businesses to grow and become, you know, what they have the potential to be. So right. It's a great program. I'm so excited about it.
You talk about on your website that entrepreneurs earn the right to serve their customers.
Yeah.
Could you expand on that just a little bit?
Yeah. Well, you know, I think it's kind of based in the idea of what I call the law of the win-win. You know, it's an honor to be able to serve. And, you know, having something to sell, you know, having a product or service that people buy is not a right. We're not entitled to it, you know. So serving people and making a difference, I mean, that's the values that all of my clients are guided by. I just think at an intuitive level. But, you know, we need to be able to really deliver on what we're giving to the marketplace, to our customers. And so that's actually part of the marketing mix. Marketing at its core, you know, the first quadrant, the four P's of marketing. We're actually talking about this tomorrow. The first quadrant is product. You know, what are you selling? And I mean, that's the best way to market yourself.
And who are you selling it to?
Yeah, and the customer experience is the fourth, you know. You know, what kind of experience are you really giving them? And it's important. It's your business will begin to take on a life of its own, and the revenue streams will run on their own when you really master serving the marketplace well.
One thing that you do is you equate entrepreneurs to gladiators
yes.
and alligator wrestlers.
Yes.
Could you explain that?
Yes, yes. Well, I was listening to a Tony Robbins clip one day, and he said, you know, entrepreneurs are gladiators. And I resonated with that because sometimes I feel like a gladiator, not in the like, I'm so powerful, but like I'm so beat up. And I've had to fight back, you know, so that metaphor resonated with me. But I was on a radio show one day being interviewed, and we were talking about something, and the host said, you know, well, why don't you break this down and make it really simple for people, because, you know, what you're saying just seems like it's a lot of work, and that might be intimidating to people who just want it to be easier, you know. And she's basically saying make it easy for them. And my response to her was, listen, entrepreneurs are gladiators, you know. If you don't know how to get in there and fight a good fight and really wrestle, and I don't know if you've ever trained for, like, you know, a race or a marathon, or if you're ever involved in sports, you know, you don't get to a level where you can be competitive by doing easy things. You know, you get to a level where you can compete by being disciplined and engaging in the right kinds of activities. And, you know, I mean, that's being an entrepreneur it's not for the faint of heart. But the beautiful thing about it is for the people that have that fire in their belly, you know, they typically will resonate with that idea that entrepreneurs are gladiators. You know, we do wrestle the alligators at times, but we don't want it to be like that all the time. You know, my whole MO is like, I want to wrestle the alligator once, and then we're going to learn from that and put together some systems and processes to make it easier. And I don't really like wrestling alligators nights and weekends. You know, it happens sometimes, but, you know, we want to figure that out, and let's put a process together that's going to streamline this a little bit, and, you know, it makes our work a lot more rewarding and fun.
Right.
So,
now, your coaching program, how is it structured? Is it all by phone, all face-to-face?
Well,
how do people take advantage of it?
Yeah. I mean, my clients are all over the country, so the face-to-face part is hard.
Yeah.
If they're in Nashville, where I'm from, you know, we'll get together. But even then, it's so much more time consuming to do a lot of face-to-face meetings, so we might do that a little bit. But I have the Marketech 2 Mastermind program, which is a four-week program that Dan and I do together, and that program is really perfect for someone who's kind of looking at the next level in their business, not just for someone starting out, but, you know, I mean, our businesses go through iteration after iteration, you know, so when you're looking to that next level and you really want to kind of wrap your mind and start developing a new way of thinking and maybe get some new ideas and perspectives, the Marketech U Mastermind is, you know, just the perfect program to go through. The commitment's reasonable, the financial side is reasonable, and I really think that you're going to find in this program stuff that no one else is talking about. So that's one of the programs that we have. And then, of course, if you want more, you know, one-on-one kind of work, if you want me or people on my team to get in the trenches with you, we have a coaching program for that too. And I align the coaching program with what I call the marketing back office. I've developed a team of people that know how to execute well on strategies. And, you know, a lot of times we do marketing work, but we're also helping our clients find good resources for themselves to contract with to deliver to their customers, you know. So there's many pieces that will work, and I have a model that's pretty flexible so that you can pay for what you need, you know, and have the support there if you need it, but you're not overcommitting yourself financially. And I mean, in a way, it's almost a co-op because all of my clients use these resources, so we're able to attract really top quality talent to get support from that we don't have to write big checks for.
Right.
You know, we just, I mean, my team tracks by the minute, so you pay for what you need. So it's a nice model. It works really well, and you know, it supports people. It's no fun to do the strategy work and see my clients struggle to execute.
Right, right.
You know?
So if you could leave our viewers with one tip either on leveraging or saving time or streamlining, what would that be?
One tip. You know, I think the thing that I feel most inspired about, we actually touched on it. I am all about the law of the win-win. There is a way that you can grow your business where you win, the stakeholders in your life win, and your customers win. And if we're gonna be gladiators, you know, if we're gonna fight this thing out, it's really important that we figure out how to help everyone win. And there's ways to do that. And, you know, I would encourage people to look for the strategies and resources and teachers that are gonna help you create those win-wins so that you feel fulfilled in your work, fulfilled in what you do, you're paid well for the work that you do, and you also have clients who feel that they're really getting a lot out of what you're doing for them. You know, sometimes I think, especially on the marketing side, we get a little carried away with a little over-promising and under-delivering, and there is a way that you can do this so that everyone wins. Your team wins, you win, your partner wins, you know, your clients win, their partner wins too, and I think that's ultimately what's going to give us the most fulfillment in our work. And, you know, people want to make a difference. I would say in the speaking community in particular, that's a value that most of us share, is really caring about contributing, and we feel like we have something special to offer the world, and you can offer that special gift and honor everybody in the process.
Great. Thank you so much for being with us. Good advice.
Thank you. Thank you.
We've been speaking with Misty Williams, founder of Strategic Marketing Solutions, a marketing strategist and creator of Marketing Tech U. Thank you for watching GBDN TV and Business Notes. I'm Diane Bogino, bringing you business ideas you can bank on.